Welcome to part three of the Texas Medical Center Library video series on performing a literature search in PubMed. This video describes how to combine keywords and mesh to create a comprehensive literature search. We'll also explore using some advanced search features such as phrase searching, truncation, and the use of field tags. When conducting a thorough literature search in PubMed, the first step is to identify and search mesh for each concept in your research question. In our previous video, we searched the mesh for the first concept in our research question, myeloid leukemia. The next step in the process is to search for keywords related to that concept. The third step is to combine the results of the mesh search and the results of the keyword search to retrieve a list of articles that is both precise and complete. It's a good idea to work in a Word document to organize your search process. Documenting in this way lets you think through all the terms before conducting your search in PubMed. It also allows you to document your search in case you need to show how you obtained your search results. We've already identified the mesh for our first concept, myeloid leukemia. Click on Advanced to view the search history. Notice the syntax that PubMed has added at the end of the term. This syntax indicates that the database is searching for this term as a medical subject heading. Let's copy and paste this mesh term into our Word document. Now I'm going to start generating keywords for this term. There are a few places you can look for keywords. A good place to start is the mesh database. As we saw in the last video, each mesh record includes a list of entry terms, or synonyms. You can also look for author-supplied keywords in an article's record. These keywords, if available, appear just below the abstract. You can also skim through the abstract for more keywords. For the purposes of this demonstration, I've identified 5 keywords for myeloid leukemia. Depending on how exhaustive you want your search to be, you may want to keep going and create a list of all possible keywords. For the sake of time, we'll stick to just these 5. I'm going to use the Boolean operator OR between each of these terms. OR is used between synonyms or related words or phrases and tells the database to find articles containing any of these terms. The operators must be entered in all caps. Otherwise, PubMed will not recognize them. Now that I've got my Boolean operators entered, I'm going to look for words that I can truncate. The truncation symbol, an asterisk, allows me to search for all possible variations of a word. Placing an asterisk after the A in leukemia will allow me to search for both the singular and plural versions of the word. I'm also going to place double quotes around any terms containing more than one word. This is called phrase searching. PubMed allows the use of phrase searching and truncation at the same time, but you can only truncate the last word in a phrase. Be sure to double check for any typos or spelling errors before going to the next step. I've misspelled granulocytic in this phrase, so I'll correct that before I move on. Now that we have our keyword line complete, let's go back to PubMed and paste this into our search box. Here's where we can decide to search certain fields in PubMed. Each PubMed record consists of different fields, such as journal name, title, author, abstract, etc. You can search any of these fields by selecting from the drop-down menu next to the search box. For a keyword search, we recommend using the combination field search TI/AB or title/abstract. This field allows you to search the title, abstract, and author-supplied keywords associated with each record. Click here to add the keywords to the query box. Notice that PubMed automatically creates the correct syntax for you. Instead of clicking Search, you can select Add to History. PubMed adds your search to the history and displays the number of results generated. Now that we have conducted both a mesh and keyword search for the concept of myeloid leukemia, we're ready to combine these together with OR. We're telling the database to bring us articles that contain the concept of myeloid leukemia either as a mesh term or a keyword. We can do this by typing the line number into the query box with the OR operator. By searching both mesh and keywords, we can be sure that our search is both precise and thorough. Don't be intimidated by the large number of search results. When we combine our concepts together with AND, this number will go down. Searching PubMed in this way can be thought of as a building block approach. We start with the mesh search and add that to our keyword search. Adding those searches together results in the first building block. The next building block consists of mesh and keyword searches for all the remaining concepts in our research question. Once we have all the blocks in place, we can combine them with the Boolean operator AND to get our final list of results. To proceed with the next building block in our literature search, let's move on to the next concept of risk factors. Searching this term in the mesh database, I can see that there are narrower terms included beneath it. I don't want to include those in my search, so I'll check the box next to Do Not Include Mesh Terms Found Below This Term. This tells PubMed that I don't want to explode this term. I'll also examine the entry terms for potential keywords. Next, I'll add it to the search builder and copy and paste the mesh into my Word document. The syntax here indicates we're searching the mesh term without exploding the term. Click Search PubMed to run the search and click on Advanced to return to the search history. Next, I'll paste my line of keywords into the search box. Select the Title Abstract field, add it to the query box, and add it to the history. Again, I'll combine these lines with OR. The last concept in our research question is children. Again, I'll search the term in the mesh database. There is a narrower term under this subject heading that I want to include in my search, so I'll leave the Do Not Explode button unchecked. I'll add that mesh to my Word document and type in my list of keywords. Adding phrase searching or truncation where necessary. Perform the keyword search and combine those lines with OR. Now it's time to combine these three concepts with AND. AND tells PubMed to bring us articles containing all of these concepts together. Again, I can use the query box to enter the line numbers with the appropriate operator, making sure to put it in all capital letters. Once you get your final results, you can look through the titles and abstracts to scan for the most relevant articles. In our final video of the series, we'll explore ways in which you can further refine your search results in PubMed using filters and limiters, and we'll demonstrate how to export your search results into a citation management system, such as RefWorks. If you have questions about searching PubMed, please contact a librarian.